I'm Ted Underwood, and I'm a professor here at the School of Information Sciences. I also have an appointment in the English department. And I study really data science in the humanities, I think is the broadest category that I could use. The thing about data science is it's not just what we used to talk about as quantitative methods, things that are easy to count, like demographics. But it's a way of making arguments about even unstructured data, pamphlets, symphonies, novels, things that we don't think of as quantitative. Now we're able to treat them as data and pose questions about them using tools that don't have to reduce it all down to two or three variables. It's actually a huge benefit to me being here that Illinois has a connection to HathiTrust Digital Library, because that's an enormous part of what I do. Most of the research I do is in some way related to a digital library, and HathiTrust is a great one to work with. HathiTrust is making it possible for me basically to go into a sealed room where all that fiction exists and to pose questions about what's there, to actually do my research in that sealed, secure chamber without violating the laws that surround copyrighted books. But I can learn about, you know, the millions of volumes that otherwise I wouldn't be able to do research on, so it's just crucial. The big picture of my research really is we have large digital libraries now with like 16 million volumes. We've been used to studying the literary past book by book, author by author, reading them one at a time. And there's a lot you learn that way. But there are also some big patterns that are like the curve of the horizon. You don't necessarily see it at ground level. You have to get up to 30,000 feet before you even realize that the horizon is curved. And that's what we're discovering with literary history as well. When you get up to 30,000 feet, so to speak, when you're studying hundreds of thousands of books, you discover that literary standards move really slowly and keep moving in the same direction for a century at a time, for instance. You can pose questions about genre, like science fiction or gothic fiction. And sometimes we see those changing really slowly, but sometimes you can say, okay, Edgar Allan Poe, the detective story, that's really where it started. And do things like confirm that by actually training a model on 19th century detective stories and proving that it can still pick the modern ones out of a lineup, so to speak. So there's a lot of ways that digital libraries, but also new methods, are making it possible to glimpse these big cultural patterns across a long timeline that we haven't really been able to see clearly before.